Bhimbetka Rock Shelters. The rock shelters and caves of Bhimbetka have a number of interesting paintings which depict the lives and times of people who lived in the caves. The Bhimbetka Rock Shelters exhibit the earliest traces of human life in India. Its Stone Age rock paintings are approximately 9,000 years old, making them among the world's oldest. The paintings were done in a period when microliths were evolved and are dated back to the Mesolithic period. The word Bhimbetka is said to be derived from Bhimbetka, or the seat of Bhima, one of the five Pandavas of the epic, the Mahabharata. Bhimbetka is situated within a region of Buddhist sites dated back to the 3rd century BC. It is in this environment that this enigmatic site lies, undisturbed and, as yet, artificially unaltered. Boar with oversized horns. In this painting, the body decoration restored several times, especially the design in the middle, and have eroded the upper layer of paint, exposing the lower, earlier design. Depiction of a shaman or wizard named Nataraj, the Lord of Dance, by Dr. Vakankar. The masked dancer holds a trident-like staff, incidentally also the symbol of Shiva, in his left hand. Both arms are profusely decorated. In this hunting scene, look at the designs on the body of the large boar and the X-ray style used for the pigs lower down. The humans near the boar look so small and insignificant. Bhimbetka as being a habitation of man from early time. The excavations carried out at Bhimbetka have yielded evidence of continuous human occupation from Lower Paleolithic till medieval times. In the long span of time, there were numerous changes took place in the social and cultural life of human being. The cultural remains such as stone tools, pottery, burials and significantly rock paintings depict the development in the human life. Of these, rock art is the best source to know about the contemporary society from the time of Mesolithic to medieval period. In general, the subject matter of the paintings are human and animal figures, composite figures such as hunting scenes, battle scenes and cultural scenes that include dancers and musicians, daily life and many more, painted with mineral colors mainly ochre and white. The untouched natural settings of Bhimbetka, water bodies and landscape add the scenic beauty and splendor of the area. Due to its integrated entity, the painted rock shelters at Bhimbetka were inscribed on UNESCO's World Heritage List in 2003. Two of criterion for selection were: Bhimbetka reflects a long interaction between people and the landscape, as demonstrated in the quantity and quality of its rock art. Bhimbetka is closely associated with the hunting and gathering economy, as demonstrated in the rock art and in relics of this tradition in the local Adivasi village on the periphery of the site. Painted rock shelter of Bhimbetka. The rock shelters of Bhimbetka, inscribed as World Heritage by UNESCO, are located about 45 kilometers northeast of Bhopal, the state capital of Madhya Pradesh. Situated along the Bhopal-Hoshangabad highway, these shelters bear proximity to the Biapura village in Resen district. The fringes of the ancient Vindhyachal ranges are home to the extraordinary rock shelters and paintings. Its awesome rocks are fortifying the ancient treasure within. Situated amidst lush greenery of dense forests, rocky terrain and craggy cliffs, the rock shelters of present a breathtaking view extended to Abedul Laganj, a small town in the Bhimbetka vicinity of Bhimbetka. Bhimbetka, 22 degrees 56.05 N, 77 degrees 36 feet 41 inches A, is a group of rock shelters part of craggy sandstone formation in the Vindhya range. It rising over 100 meters above the Deccan traps amidst the Ratapani Wildlife Sanctuary. The area is rich in heritage. There are over 700 rock shelters in this region. Of these, more than 400 rock shelters are distributed over the five hills Ratapani Wildlife Sanctuary. These hills are Ibineka 2, Bhonrawali 3, Bhimbetka IV, Lakhava East and V Lakhava West. Another group of rock shelters, V, located in the buffer zone known as M Baba Ki Pahari. Bhimbetka group consists 243 rock shelters, in which 138 have rock paintings. Excavation and cultural remains. Bhimbetka is being inhabited from early days. To study the cultural development of human beings, many excavations were carried out. Summarizing the evidence from all the excavations, the following cultural sequence emerges at Bhimbetka. In the Lower Paleolithic period, that is C 100,000-40,000 years, evidence of pebble tool assemblage below the Acheulean deposit with a sterile layer in between is a remarkable finding. The notable feature of Middle Paleolithic, that is, c. 40,000-20,000 years, is that a number of tools are made on flat natural stones instead of on flakes. The characteristic feature of Upper Paleolithic period, circa 20,000-10,000 years, is the increase in the proportion of smaller and slender blades. The Mesolithic, that is c. 10,000-2,500 years, people used microlithic tools on siliceous material like chert and chalcedony. During this period, maximum number of shelters and caves were occupied, that clearly show an increase in human population. The Mesolithic people regularly used fire, as is testified by the presence of ash, charcoal and charred bones and antlers. These people made floors with flat stone slabs and stone boulder wall to partition the cave into compartments. After the discovery of metals such as copper and iron, the hunter-gatherer way of life slowly transformed to life on the plains to practice of agriculture. Earth and solar system. Since it is thought the bodies in the solar system may have formed at similar times, scientists analyzed moon rocks collected during the moon landing and even meteorites that have crash-landed on Earth. Both of these materials dated to between 4.4 and 4.5 billion years. Earth is estimated to be 4.54 billion years old, plus or minus about 50 million years. Scientists have scoured the Earth searching for the oldest rocks to radiometrically date. In northwestern Canada, they discovered rocks about 4.03 billion years old. Then, in Australia, they discovered minerals about 4.3 billion years old. Researchers know that rocks are continuously recycling, due to the rock cycle, so they continued to search for data elsewhere. Since it is thought the bodies in the solar system may have formed at similar times, scientists analyzed moon rocks collected during the moon landing and even meteorites that have crash-landed on Earth. Both of these materials dated to between 4.4 and 4.5 billion years. Scientists have recorded five significant ice ages throughout the Earth's history: the Huronian, 2.4-2.1 billion years ago; Cryogenian, 850 to 635 million years ago; Andean Saharan, 460 to 430 million years ago; Karoo, 360-260 million years ago; and Quaternary, 2.6 million years ago. In the present ice age, Earth is currently in the midst of an ice age, as the Antarctic and Greenland ice sheets remain intact despite moderate temperatures. After the ice caps melt, the present ice age will end. The next ice age is expected in 80,000 years. At the end of ice ages, almost all life on Earth dies and several species become extinct as a common feature. During the breakup of Pangaea, the Indian subcontinent became isolated from the southern part of Pangaea, called Gondwanaland, at around 130 ma, moved northwards and eventually collided with Eurasia to form the Himalayas at around 40 to 50 ma. Aravalli Dharwar Singhabhum. India was made by these three plates. When these three plates were collided, then there was a formation mountain. They are fold mountains and they are created by forcing of plates on either sides. The gap between Vindhya and Satpura is considered as Rift Valley and River Narmada is passing between them. Researchers have discovered three fossils of the earliest known living animal, the 550 million-year-old Dickinsonia, on the roof of the Bhimbetka rock shelters, about 40 kilometers from Bhopal. One can identify the fossils from the white leaf-like patches with the central vertebra, that is central midrib and connecting veins. The fossils were found in the roof of Auditorium Cave at Bhimbetka. As per news, the ASIA noticed the fossils because those were before human evolution. As per the news on it, the discovery of Dickinsonia in India allows assessment of biogeographic provinces and plate tectonic reconstructions for the late Ediacaran, it says, adding, this new occurrence confirms assembly of Gondwanaland by 550 ma, but not reconstructions adjusted for true polar wander. Claudina and other small shelly marine fossils were low latitude, but vendobionts such as Dickinsonia were at temperate to subtropical latitudes. Bhimbetka is visible only if enough daylight is there. Several parts will be in shades.
निकलते हैं। हम लोग क्या करते हैं, जो आज देखता है हम उसको मान लेते, अरे साहब ये रास्ता खुदाई करके बने, ये मिट्टी से दबा हुआ था, ये तो 2022 में अपन लोग देख रहे हैं ना, जब बाकनकर जी को ये मिला था ना, ये पूरा जंगल उबड़ खाबड़ था, 15 साल तक ये खुदाई हुई, एक्सकवेशन हुए, उसके बाद ये रास्ते बने ही, ऐसा की बात है।
तो प्लेटफॉर्म इतना,
प्लेटफॉर्म इतना रहा होगा ना, ह्यूमन की हाइट हम बड़ी मानते हैं ना छोटी मानते हैं, ह्यूमन जैसा है
वैसे। लेकिन ये जो निग्रिटो रेस बोलते हैं ना, जो जंगलों में आज भी ट्राइबल रह रहे हैं, पूर्वज, हाँ उनका हाइट ज़्यादा होता है निग्रिटो वाला।
हाँ ये बात सही है। अब ये देख लो, ये मार की ना यूपी पत्थर से कार्य कर गए। अब ये क्या है इसके बारे में, तो ASI इसको सर्टिफाइड नहीं करता है, पर हम ये कह सकते हैं ह्यूमन भी फर्स्ट मैन मेड एक्टिविटी के और ये स्मूथ होता है नेचुरल, ये देखो ये स्मूथ, हाथ लगाओ उसमें, हाथ लगाओ रफ लगेगा, सैंड का पार्ट दिखता है, जैसे आज भी यदि मैं इसको ड्रॉ करूंगा ना, कार्व करूंगा तो थोड़ा दर्द आ जाएगा।
Rock shelter number 4, the semicircular shelter has a large projection measuring 14 mx 6.2 meters having 3.4 meters high ceiling and a smooth and sloping floor of 3.3 meters above ground. It has been named Zoo Rock by Sri V.S. Wakankar because depiction of the large number and variety of naturalistic and elegant animal drawings. There are 453 figures in the shelter comprising 252 animals of 16 species, 90 human engaged in several activities, 2 rodents, squirrels, 1 bird, cock, 6 decorative designs, 2 enclosures identified as snares, 1 inscription in Sankha script and 99 fragmented figures. The shelter is richly decorated with as many as 10 layers of superimposed figures. Most drawings belong to the prehistoric period and few belong to historical period of the 6th century. BCE onwards. Rock Shelter Number 5. This shelter has two chambers, one above the other. Paintings are present in both chambers, nicely executed in both white and red ochre color pigments. The upper chamber has the painted image of goat, deer and other animals. There is a beautiful depiction of langur leaping around a tree.
व्यू बहुत मस्त है यार यहाँ।
Rock Shelter Number 10, most of the pictures in this shelter are not easy to identify. There are depictions of a bird on a tree, most probably peacock or peafowl painted on the left side of the wall. Besides, paintings of swordsmen, a deer and eight figures of drummers and dancers, all painted in white, are also visible. Rock Shelter Number 11, this shelter has depictions related to historical period. The figures are mostly painted in white color, however, in some paintings a borderline in red ochre color has been given. Group of horse rider and foot soldiers can be seen at various places. Rock shelter number 7, all figures in this shelter belong to historical period. One can see the figure of a swordsman riding a caparisoned horse on the ceiling below. There is depiction of 6 horse riders in which the third is the larger as compared to the others. Rock shelter number 6, this is a small narrow shelter facing east, contains beautifully depicted natural looking animal drawings in white color. 3 different layers of superimposition have been identified in the paintings. The earlier levels of paintings are now faded, which can be identified in red colored animal shown on the right side of this shelter. Rock Shelter Number 13, the paintings in this shelter are executed in the higher point. In this shelter, two figures of Varaha, meaning boar, have been painted in two different cavities situated in the ceiling of the shelter. The first one is very similar but smaller in size to the figure of mythical boar as found in the rock shelter No. 3C19 Boar Rock. A heap of boars is also depicted in the lower part. It is a hunting scene where 5 to 6 men are shown. The body of the boar is decorated with geometric designs. The famous Boar Rock is situated in the back side of this shelter. Rock Shelter Number 14, the height of this shelter is about 6 meters. Scene of carrying a dead boar is very beautifully executed in this shelter. This whole scene is shown in white color. The group hunting scene included 11 men as depicted here. They are holding bow and arrow in their hands. The vermilion figures include 2 elephant riders, an unfinished animal image and drawings of 3 buffaloes in creamy white are seen. In this drawing, the animal with a sturdy body decorated with honeycomb pattern, tapering legs and large horns are shown. Rock Shelter Number 15, also called Boar Rock, this mushroom-shaped giant rock is famous for a large silhouetted figure of a boar-like animal which is painted at a height of 9.85 meters from the ground. The animal depicted with 2 crescent horns, a massive snout with mustaches and bristles on the back, unusually large with composite features, is clearly mythical. Near its snout is the figure of a fleeing man and in front of him that of a crab. The hooves of the hind legs are overlapped by the figure of a buffalo facing in the opposite direction. Besides, there are depictions of human and animal figures. The animal figures mainly include buffalo, cow, rhinoceros and langur etc. Rock Shelter Number 12, this shelter has paintings of different type of animals. In one side, a buffalo with large horns is painted and to it right, is the depiction of galloping, nige. Very interesting paintings of 4 fleeing cheetal doe in a vertical row are depicted as if they are diving down from an elevated cliff. Here, the painter has used the particular morphology of rock as background to the painting so as to convey the meaning of the art in a more effective style.